Welcome to Dark Venture Second Edition. This is going to be so much fun, I promise you, because there has never been a play of this game that wasn't absolutely incredible. So what we're going to do today is take a look at the setup here real quick. Go ahead and pause it if you want to read the story right above there. And then we have the solo rules. So you'll notice there's some differences. First of all, I just have to make this very clear. Second edition rules are phenomenal, and they are quite different from the first edition. So if you're familiar with the rule set of this game and you're wondering why things are a certain way, it's because this is second edition. The rules are completely different. And we have solo rules here where some cards are out of the game. So that's at the top if you want to read that. Those have already been removed. I put them in my box here. They're somewhere in this mess. And then you get to draw four heroic quests, choose two, and shuffle the rest back. Then the player draws three side quests and accepts them all. Instead of drawing one location, character, or item card at the beginning of each turn, draw two cards instead. I love that. That rule makes this so much better, along with being able to play the location and a character for free, and a maximum hand of seven. So they're a little bit different. So let's see. I did not give myself a starting hand either, so let's... Our starting hand is one location, one character, and two items. Now, the game does give you this nice little board to put these on there. I find that with sleeved cards, they don't fit so well. So I just kind of have it sitting behind it for me. What did we start with here? So we have Wester's Dirt Hole. And yes, I'm going to say it like that every time I read it. Wester's Dirt Hole. We have Princess Bretta. Where's a tactical vest? A cryptic map and leather body armor. Reduce speed by one while equipped. That's a bummer. Okay, but it's plus one armor, and I have zero armor. We are going to be playing. I should probably jump into our character. Dead the Fierce holds a longbow, a survival knife. So that's what I've started with here. And let's see here. Adds plus one to all ranged weapon checks. I don't know what a check is. Okay. Fixed arrows. Once per battle, I will never remember to use this special ability. When using a bow, roll 1d6 on a roll of 4, add plus 2 damage to each of his bow attacks for the battle, and that ends after the battle. Now, he starts with a bow and a survival knife. So the survival knife looks like this. So when you're low on HP, that's why I've got this little cube here to remind me that when I cross that, I actually gain a bonus from my survival knife if I have it equipped. And we have this awesome longbow, which lets me shoot two zones away as long as they're in a straight line for free. Just a d6 damage once per turn. That's awesome. That's awesome. So you could use that up to 6 times in a game. So we'll see how that goes. Now, we also have... What do I got to do here? Okay. Before I forget, I always forget to draw the cards that you can start the game with. Like on turn one, where it says right there, draw a card, right? So I get to draw two cards, okay? Phase one, card draw. I always forget that in the beginning, so I'm going to do it right away. Knowing what my starting hand is, I think I'm going to draw an item, and I'm going to draw a location, which is this. Okay, so the item we drew, how funny, is a different bow, and Gargan's Clearing. Okay, so one other really cool thing I found about this game, we have to draw our quest still, let's just get that out of the way, I guess, is that 1, 2, 3, we have Heavy Hitter. Equip a two-handed weapon and keep it equipped for 2 game rounds. Okay, that seems easy enough. Drop or discard egg armor. What is this junk? Gain 1 quest point, and then this one is get out and do something. Enter 3 different locations that have hex actions. Okay. So there's those. We have to draw 4 of these. 1, 2, 3, 4. Alrighty. And then we get to pick 2. Heroic Quest, Cursed. Okay, so that's an option here. You trip over the arm of a half-buried man. You know him. He is Rake the Void, an evil warlock. He scowls at you, and with his last breath, he quietly whispers an evil incantation, then slumps over dead. You are encircled by a dark mist. Lose 2 health now, and at the beginning of each new round, instead of gaining 2 health, your hero or their follower must drop 6 items onto the ground and never be picked up by you... or by your hero or their followers again, gain 1 quest point for each of the 6 items that are dropped, then discard this card to end the curse. Okay, that's interesting. It's What else do we have here? Foraging Warrior. You have made a pledge to become a member of the Legionnaires, a militia group working for the king. One of your lesser pledge duties is to scour the land for resources. Pick up items that have been dropped by characters you do not control, looted from bodies, or drawn through searching locations. Bring these items to the crossroads and deliver them to the Legionnaires by discarding them. Gain one quest point for each discarded item. It almost sounds like you could stack those quests pretty well. But I think that one would, like, go away. I don't know. Save the Prince. The heir to the kingdom was lost on a hunting expedition, and the king has given you the task of finding him. He has led a sheltered life and won't last long in this harsh land. If Prince Braggot has been or is already in play, discard this heroic quest and draw another. Don't I have... Oh, I have the princess. Princess Bretta. Okay, you know, I kind of want to take that just because it's cool, right? Because I have the princess here. In two game... Oh, okay. If not, draw him, shuffle after, or reveal him if he is in hand in two game rounds at the beginning of the round or whenever possible after. Oh, so I have to do that, like, now. So let's put a little marker in two game rounds. So on turn three, and we need to have the dude down here. Prince Braggot, huh? Oh, he was... way towards the bottom. Okay. What does he have for gear? Nothing. Oh, he's a follower. Yeah, okay, so no gear. Okay, I like that. That makes it easy for me. I don't have to go shuffling this next. Okay. At the beginning of the round. Okay, so... and bring him to the crossroads as your hero's follower, then discard him. Gain 6 quest points. Okay, so we have to remember that. This is our starting hand. And poisoned is our other thing. Poisoned. Construct faction characters must shuffle this heroic quest back and draw another. We are not that. We are Lightning Bolt. Warlock. So we're a warlock faction. That's what we are. Okay. In the middle of the night, while walking to quiet your mind after a horrible nightmare, you stumbled into a viper's nest and were bitten. The viper's poison was not deadly, but you must wash the wound soon or you could die from it. Your hero takes 1d6 damage at the beginning of every round instead of gaining 2 health. Ooh, a d6 damage every round until they enter a location with water in it. 2, 6, 11, 12, and 24. And I think there's only 24 locations in this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Ooh. After entering one of these locations, your hero washes their wounds and regains 12 health. You gain 4 quest points. Ooh. So I kind of like only losing 2 hit points, but I've got to drop a lot of stuff forever. Huh. I mean, I could very easily knock half of that out, right? Ooh, what do we do? Do we take the water one or do we take the cursed one? Wow, this is nuts. Let's take the cursed one then. This one sounds like it's terrible. So let's just take constant damage. Is that what we think we're going to do with ourselves? Sure. So that right there gives us 10 points, right? If we can do the Save the Prince and find some water, that's 10 quest points. And we only need to go to 15 on a short game, which is to round 6 here. Okay, so when you're playing this by yourself, this game goes super quick. When you're sitting here talking and doing all this, it takes a while. So the short game, I think, might work best for our purposes today here. Okay, so I am cursed. A d6 damage. So I'm never going to remember that I'm poisoned, rather, not cursed. So let's put this here to denote that I am poisoned. That's how I don't have, like, a poison marker. Oh, I guess I could use a green cube. Stuff the game came with. There we go. I like that. Okay. 1d6 damage at the beginning of every round. Guess what? It's the beginning of a round. We start the game with 4 damage on us. Oh, great. So we're at 31. Dead the Fears here starts at 35 HP. I like to build a little wall out of some excess cubes to make sure I know where my maximum is. So we just took 4 damage to start the game. Okay. Terrific. Let's see here. So we have quite the hand of cards to begin with. Man, this would have been easy to get rid of that other one. And now I need egg armor. Oh my god. All right, well, let's start by searching. Yeah, see? I can even start by searching. So search is a D6 plus your mind. Is it on here somewhere? D6 plus mind. My mind is 5. I am rock solid. Oh, you know what I wanted to do is I wanted to read this. How cool is this? I didn't know this was in the back of the blue book. But there's like a little story. Ow. Just wrapped by knuckles on my table. Dead the Fierce is an arch lieutenant in the Guild of Warlocks and likely one of the most skilled magic users in the Dark Range. He has been severely disfigured by a degenerative temporal condition that requires him to wear a protective steel exoskeleton. He lives the life of a nomadic vagabond but manages to remain very active in the guild. His temper is legendary. Oh, legendary. And then, of course, the crossroads. All crucial decisions are made at a crossroads. Players begin the game here, placing the tokens or standees that represent their heroes onto this location. Now, let me get this out of the way. These are location cards and character cards, and you get to play one for free each round, so I'm just using these markers to remind me that I can do that, because we get three actions per round plus one of each of those for free. So that's why these cubes are here. I'm going to use a black cube because it's easy for you to see, as opposed to my character thing bouncing around here. It's just, this is easier to see on the overhead camera. So let's go ahead and search. We are going to take that, and it's even if you fail, you've still searched the zone and can never do it again, the location. So I need an 8 or better. Is that the case? We got a 3 plus 5 is, barely. So I got an 8. So we search. So we get 3, and we get to pick 1. So we have the metal shield, which cannot be used by ghost characters. I like that because it gives me... but I have a two-handed bow at the moment. What else do we have? A spear. That's not kind of great. And then we have the Koss knife. Ooh, I know a character starts with that because it has a little star up there. Oh, same with there. Poisoned blade. In battle, after calculating your attack damage, roll an additional d6. If 1 to 2, add it to your attack damage. Well, I think of the group... that might be my best bet in case I have to go dual-wielding knives, right? We'll take that. Okay, so those are done. That's that. Let's play a location for free, I guess. Let's go here. So our location, our freebie play, Gargan's Clearing. I like this one because it has 4 ways out. This will keep the map open for us. Let's just put it down here. Number 4 on the map. Or in the book, rather. Number 4, Gargan's Clearing. When the path ahead looks distorted, as if warped by heat, when a player's hero or follower enters this location, read action 22. Well, guess what? We're going to pay 1 to walk down here. We're going to read 22. That's in the green book, right? That's this one right here. We're doing the A books, if you couldn't tell. And we need action number 22. The first player's character to enter is struck by a temporal wave and begins to dream reality. Take 1 hidden card from your opponent's hand. I don't have one. If it's a character... what does that little symbol there mean? I don't know. Like, right after where it says action 22. What does that mean? I feel like I don't recall seeing that symbol anywhere. Note. Look up the solo version of an action marked with... that in the solo action section of this guide, page 25. Oh, that's what that means. Pay attention, solo players. Okay. 25. Oh, yeah, it's wildly different. Okay. Whoa. Okay, so we have to go to, looks like the back of the book. Action 22 for solo. That's too bad they didn't put it like just in line with it. I think that would have been cool. The first player's character to enter this location is struck by a temporal wave and they begin to dream reality. Roll 1d6. That's me. 1. If the roll is 1 or 2, draw a character card. Character. The plant man. Equip that character. So he has a red solar cape. And place them into this location. The red solar cape. The red solar cape. There it is. Okay. The red solar cape. Oh, and the golden sword. Oh, dear. Okay. And the golden sword. Oh, man. Why aren't they just all on one line, I guess? All right. Golden sword. Ghost sword? Golden sword. Golden sword. Oh, man. I want to kill this guy and take his stuff. I didn't find that already, did I? No, metal shield and a spear. Golden sword, glowing golden sword. Okay. Regeneration. After a battle, he regains 2 hit points. Okay. If it's a 3 or 4, draw an item card and drop the item into this location. 5 or 6, draw a location card. Place it adjacent to this location if possible. And draw a heroic quest. Okay, cool. All right. Hey, that's actually fantastic now that I read the whole ability thing here. And he is number 2. You were like the second created guy. Gargan's Clearing. You're just like hanging out here, huh, bro? You are not aggressive. So we're just going to lay you out up here. We are going to get all this crap off the screen. It said draw a heroic quest. Pledging knighthood. You've pledged your liege, the foregone king, to become one of his royal knights. He has decreed that you must explore the unclaimed wildlands of Darkgrange to find a powerful shield and a new fantastic weapon. Have your hero enter into 3-player placed locations, equip them with a new sword and a new shield, then return them with these items equipped to the crossroads to gain 4 points. What the heck? So I have to enter 3-player place locate. Well, every place I go is going to be a player place location. So I have to do at least 3 more and equip them with a new sword and a new shield. This is not a sword. This is a knife and a knife. Oh, dear. Oh, dear. Okay, well, now we suddenly have our work cut out for us. Okay, so, well, that happened. I do. Look at this. So I'm going to put this little marker here. This says, enter 3 different locations that have hex actions. That's a hex action, right? So, yeah, it's action book. I equip a 2-handed weapon and keep it equipped for 2 game rounds. Well, I have one equipped already, so I suppose that's fine for this as well. It's like a free point, that one. Okay. Oh, and I have the golden bow. Wait. Yeah, I have things I could be doing here. Okay. Maybe we, just to make it kind of more legit here, let's see. For 1 AP, hit a character in an adjacent location for 2d6 damage. Roll 1d6 plus luck. If 6, they move to your location and attack you. Speed shot. Take a second battle turn. Okay, so you know what? Maybe we'll do this just to make sure that's a little bit more legit. That's a different 2-handed weapon so that I can accomplish this. We'll do that. Then we have the armor. Oh, we have to adjust our stuff. That's down 2 plus 1. That's still 1, and this is up 2. Wow, that would have been good to see. And then if we equip leather body armor, that's going to give us 1 luck, 1 defense, but minus 1 speed. Okay. All right. There we go. We got some stuff out of our hands. All right. Looking good. So Princess Bretta here, she's a hero. Dang. I thought she'd be a follower like the prince. The prince is coming out in 2 rounds. Ah, dear. Well, I only have 1 more action. I could place her. She has a tactical vest, holds a metal shield in Torgon's Edge. Ooh. You know what? For free, we may as well put her in the game. Princess Bretta. We'll put her right here. She is character number 1. Look at that. And she has a tactical vest, a metal shield, and Torgon's Edge. Oh my god. Torgon's Edge, I'm never going to find all these things in one pass-through, right? Prism Sword? No. Torgon's Edge, metal shield... metal shield and tactical vest. Metal shield, tactical vest. Where would that be? Tactical vest. Look at that. Wow, she's decked out. But yeah, she's a hero. Of course she is. Okay. Royal privilege. Once per game, she may take 1 item from any other character while in their location. +2 to her follower rolls. Wow. Yeah, we'll put her right there. I don't know yet. Maybe we'll drop some nasty, aggressive guy right there to fight her. And then that way she can die and leave all these amazing items to me. Look, that's all I needed, these 2 things in that zone right there. So that's setting up for the future of the fledgling knighthood quest, or pledging knighthood. I just got to go do some exploration. Okay, so all right, well, we're in good shape now. We have 1 action left. We may as well search here. Now that I'm at a 7, I can roll even a 1, right? 5, 6, 7. I can roll even a 1 and still find an 8. So there's 1, 2, 3. We searched. So we're going to put this here. And oh, all of these are good. Look at this. Bitter Blood. I love that. Bitter Blood Tonic. Dang, I would love to have that and draw that again. Arcane Map and the Rift Crystal. I think I'm going to take the Bitter Blood Tonic. And the reason is because, look at that. Right? I can just drink it right now for free. Boom. I take 10 damage. So I go from 31 to 21, but I gain 5 max hit points. So now I'm at 40. Oh, I don't have enough cubes. Now I'm at 40 max. I just took 10 damage, though. But that's okay. Because now we can heal somehow, right? No, we can't. What does this do? Cryptic map. Draw 3 locations, pick one, shuffle the rest back. Place this location for no AP cost this turn. If possible, then read the location guide entry for it. On this turn, your character can move there for no AP cost. Discard this card after it's been used. I'm going to equip that just so that he has it. And then that is the end of turn number one, I think. So at the end of the turn, we have to refill our actions. Everybody heals for 2. 1, 2. Oh, no, wait. I'm poisoned. That's right. I'm not going to heal, but I'm going to take a D6 damage, right? Although I need to find water. There's no water here. I take a D6 damage because I suck, right? That's right. Oh, my God. 4 damage. Uh-oh. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4. I couldn't do math there for a second. Okay. New round, and everybody's fully healed. I'm going to use these. The game gives you a million ways to track damage and life and everything. I'm going to use these as wounds, I think, instead of as hit points for, like, NPCs here. Now, I also have the option... this egg armor. I could get rid of a quest and switch it out with something. What else do we have here? Save the prince. This guy's going to pop out next round. Next round, I'll get that, as long as I keep my bow equipped. Then she needs to die somehow. So these are all things that need to happen somehow. Okay, let's go ahead and... oh, I got to draw some cards. I need... well, let's... so what I'm agonizing over is, do I switch this one out for that? What are the chances of me finding egg armor? Not very good. So let's switch out the egg armor and get ourselves a new quest. Are you serious? Oh my god. Okay, well, shucks. It would have been easier that... oh god. How does this happen to me? Let's take a location. Bilkid's Pond. That... 6 has water. 2, 6, 11, 12, and 24. Well, we know what we're playing this round. Temporal Beacon. Temporal Matter Transfer. When equipped for one action point, roll 1d6. If the roll's 5, 6, draw any one item from the item discard. That could be amazing. Oh my god. This game is nuts. I just played the most amazing game before I started this recording too, as well. And I lost by 1 point because I was dumb. So let's see here. We could... and I had it made, and I just made a mistake, and I couldn't get that last point. Oh my god. So, like, this is amazing. The problem with that is rolling the 5 or 6, because I would take that Bitter Blood Tonic again and suck it down again and get even more hit points. That's a one-handed item, though, so I can't. Okay. All right. So, my turn has been decided. Location is the green one. Location. I have to put Bilkid's Pond here no matter what it does. Let's put it down here. Actually, that'll be the bottom of our map now, so maybe I can just move this down here. Because there's no way out. Oh, I can go this way, I guess. There is a way out. Okay. So, Bilkid's Pond is a 6 on the booklet. Let's see. Oh, I'm on the page. Bilkid's Pond. There is a deep, burbling moan that echoes up from the road. You see a pond ahead that appears to have a small wooden dock and might have a boat moored to it. Nearby, there's a large sign that has a colorful trail map posted to it. When a player's hero or follower enters this location, read action 39. Okay, well, I have to go here because I'm poisoned, which is super dumb. But I figured there's a good chance that I would burn through location cards until I hit this quest, right? So, so here we are. So now it's poisoned, right? So here's this. Your hero so no more taking damage. After entering one of these locations, your hero washes their wounds. Oh, and gains 12. So 1, 2, so we're at 29. So we're here. And 4 quest points. So it's not a ton for, because it's kind of an easy one. It's just walk around and burn through those cards, but doable at least. Okay, so we're down to these now. Cool. We have to, like, read something. Read action 39. Ooh, and this is another one of these. Okay, so read action 39. Action 39 should be right here. By the pond, there is a map posted, though it's partially destroyed, and a small wooden boat floating near the dock. For one action point, I have one left. If someone hasn't already, a hero or weapon-wielding follower who enters this location... that's interesting. Read the map, action 001. destroy the map. Why? Get in the boat or untie the boat. I mean, or I could just like not do anything here, and I'm kind of cool with that as well. I've never seen this card, I don't think. I don't think I have any idea what any of this stuff does. So let's read the map. That seems like, why would you destroy the map? Ooh, what if it's like a location to a bad thing? So let's go destroy the map. So destroy, oh, it cost me one action point. Right, that was 39. So read the map, action number one. I'm gonna turn this back just because you don't wanna see the pages flip through. Action number one. Look at that, right there on the top it says, that symbol means read solo actions, duh. Your current location on the posted map is marked by an arrow labeled You Are Here. Sections of the map are unreadable, but you can make out directions to various nearby locations that look interesting. Draw one location card into your hand, if possible, discarding an item or character from your hand if necessary. Once per turn for one action... Wait, what? Draw one location card in your hand, if possible, discarding an item or character from your hand if necessary. Once per turn for one action point... Two more location cards can be drawn this way by any player with a hero or weapon holding follower in this location. Oh, wow. This might be kind of cool to just stand here and farm points. What did I get? Wesker's Dirt Hole and Barnard's Grave. I think I had the Dirt Hole from the beginning. So that's what I drew for free. My blue one is a character. I don't have a character to play, so I guess that's... Wow, that was a fast round too, huh? So, oh, we're no longer poisoned. We can get rid of this. And we can heal for two like everybody else. Okay, good deal. Now, the question is, so this heavy hitter, equip a two-handed weapon and keep equipped for two game rounds. I guess that goes away, so I gain 1 point now. And then I don't think I would draw one, but right, because I started the round with it. No, that starts at the beginning of the round. Yeah, sure. So do I just draw another one, or would I have to switch this out? I think that would trigger... Let's switch this one out just in the off chance I'm doing it wrong. And we'll just say that. I was going to say, well, why should it be another egg one? No, this says kill a Varpin faction character. Varpin faction is the green symbol there, the fourth one down. So that green eyeball. We have a plant man here. We have a plant and we have a the queen here, the aristocrats. So we need to find a Varpin character. Okay, oh, this guy. Oh, and he's the same. Okay, save the prince. So this guy came out now, right? Because it's been two game rounds. At the beginning of the round, or whenever possible after, place him in an empty location. So the only empty location... So what is an empty location? Is that... I don't know if any of these qualify as an empty location. They all have stuff. So here's how we fix that. We're going to play a card, right? We are going to play a card. Yeah? No, we're going to do this. We're going to go... Oh, I get all my stuff back, right? So we're going to go step one, step two. We're going to play a location for free. Location is my green one. So we're going to drop a location over here. I don't know. I've had Wesker's Dirt Hole for a while. Let's throw down... Yeah, neither one of these have a this on it because I need those points. So Wesker's Dirt Hole is number 8 in the book. So let's go to the good book and find Wesker's Dirt Hole. The hole that Wester has dug here contains a matter transfer portal into another dimension. Once per turn for one action point while a player-controlled hero or follower is in this location, their player may roll 1d6 plus luck. If 7 or lower, the player discards an item from their character's inventory to draw an item into their hand. If 8 to 10, they discard up to 2 items from their character's inventory to draw the same number. Oh, that's cool. You can like farm out dumb crap. Okay, if 11 or higher, they shuffle an item from their character's inventory into the item deck, drawing any character or any card from the item discard pile into their hand. I want to farm those hit points, dude. Okay, so this is now an empty location. I think maybe that's how that works. So let's go ahead and throw this guy in here. He spawned there. I can move over here. There's all my points. And then this says he's a follower. On each turn in this location, so I'm in this location, I need some dice, roll 2d6 plus luck, my luck. Now before I do this, can I get more luck? Nope. My luck is only 4. I need to roll not a 3 to 8s. 2d6 plus luck. So I rolled an 11 plus 4 is 15. So I think we succeeded in picking this dude up as a follower, right? On a 3 to 8, he runs two locations. On 9 plus, he joins your hero. Okay, cool. So I'm not going to worry about decking him out and putting the board and all this stuff together, because I'm dumping this guy at the crossroads just because it's next door. So we're just going to put him right there. He's with me now. We're in Wesker's dirt hole. I'm out of turns unless I want to play a character. I do not have a character. This is going a little fast. Yeah? Okay. So we're done. That was, oh my gosh. We're on to round 4 now. So I'm going to heal 2. I haven't done any combats yet. Look at that. We're going to do this. We're going to draw a new quest. Have 3 healing items in your hero's inventory. Well, I have 0. So, okay. Did I heal? I don't think I healed. Okay. Oh, now I gotta draw some cards. What do I need? Kill a Varpin character. So let's take a character. What are the odds of me getting 3 healing items? The Dirt Twin. Oh, I hate these idiots. He is a diamond faction. I hate those guys. And then I get one more card that is not a character. So let's take a location. I have to find one that has... one of those. Perfect. Okay. That guy, I hate him. These Dirt Twins are the bane of my existence. I had this one game where I had their sword. I was running around with it, just killing everybody. It was the only game I never drew them or the diamond mine. It was glorious. Anyway, we're here. So let's just get this done. Let's just get this done. Let's spend one action to walk over here. Hey, look at that. I just reunited the prince and the princess, right? So I'm going to drop the prince off, number 10, right? That's all I have to do, right? Could I bring the prince back and fight her? That'd be amazing. Okay. 2 game rounds. Bring him to the crossroads as your hero's follower, then discard him to gain 6 quest points. So now we're up to 11. We only need 4 more. Is this possible? Kill a Varpin, 3 healing items. Nope. Ooh, we still have this map. We might want to use this. Okay, so the map says draw 3 locations, pick one. You know what? Let's use it. Let's just use the map. Draw 3 locations. So locations are here. 1, 2, 3. Pick one and shuffle the rest back. Place this location for free. Oh, there's a. Oh, I should have used this for a water thing early on. What was I thinking here? The robot's castle, the plant man's castle, and the waterfall pit. So what's crazy is I've seen all of these before and I don't really remember what they do. So we'll take the robot castle. What does it say I do with these? It says then shuffle the rest back. So we'll put these back. Place this location for no AP this cost this turn if possible. Then read the location guide entry for it. On this turn, your character can move there for no cost. Discard this card after it has been used. That's discarded. We can totally place this here to be the top of our map. That is number 7 in the good book. We're already on that page. The robot's castle. Someone or something is standing at the door to this castle. Draw one character or take a character. Oh, crud. From your hand. Ooh, wait a second. I have the Dirt Twin. Oh, but then if I pull him out, doesn't some garbage happen? And he's immortal and all sorts of mess. Let's see here. Or a character from your hand if they are weapon wielding. Oh, let's just draw one then. Let's draw a character. Draw a character from this jerk. Haglor the Ghostly. He has a ghost sword and a dimensional jewel. So there's a ghost that runs this business, huh? Draw them 2. Oh, jeez. If they're weapon holding, draw them 2 additional items from the deck. Holy cow, so this guy's decked out. This guy has a ghost sword and a dimensional jewel. That sounds familiar. The dimensional jewel is not in this game. You can see it's taken out. So, ghost sword. Oh, wait, didn't I draw that earlier? That sounds familiar. I saw it probably when I was flipping through this. All of this stuff is starting to sound really familiar to me because I can't stop thinking about this game. There's only really one word for how I feel about this game. I am absolutely smitten with this game. I can't stop thinking about it, and I cannot tell you the last time... Oh, I can. The last time that happened to me was right after I played Dune Imperium the first time. I could not stop thinking about it. This game is incredible. I don't remember if I mentioned this or not. I finally caved and ordered all the expansions because they're still available. for now. Today is what, September 29th, 2024, and I'm bummed because it doesn't come back, or I mean, it doesn't get delivered until 2 days before I leave for vacation. I'll be gone for a week, and I'm not taking it with me. Yeah, it's still available here. This is on backerkit.com. You can still go ahead and get it. The base game for $44 is an absolute steal. I don't care. Everybody should have this if you like these kind of games. Period. End of story. And Daniel over at the Dungeon Dive just today, like 4 hours ago, I think, 5 hours ago maybe, posted a video opening all the other expansions, which is super exciting because I've never been able to like look at them. So I ended up ordering them all. It's a little pricey, but you know what? I wasn't going to do it, but this game has completely won me over. It is incredible. All right, where was I? Then they need two more things. We weren't done yet. Then draw them two additional items. So the other additional items are a vision beacon and a rift crystal. Oh, I want this rift crystal so badly. Okay, do they equip any of this garbage? Not really. Crushing this thing and meditate on one lost item. Press the button and an arcane device will send a spear of light into the sky for 1 AP. Draw any one item or blah, 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 blah. Related to a quest? Holy cow. Okay, so this guy has loads of gear. Who is this now? I thought I drew a character. Oh, he's probably in this pile. Yeah, oh, he was the second card down. Okay, so this guy's here now. He's number three. I can teleport there for free, but I'm not so sure. That guy would wreck me. Let's see here. Equip them in place in his location. The character stumbled through the open door of the robot's castle. Has claimed it as their own and will guard it with their life and becomes aggressive. So I need a way to remind myself that this guy is aggressive. So that guy is aggressive. That is not a thing from the game, but that's me remembering. So the question is now, do I go there and get wrecked by this guy? Because what would he have? 3, 4, 5. So he's at +6 damage. Oh god, and he's a ghost character, so he has 8 more base health than he looks like. Oh my goodness. I don't think I want to mess with Haglore. He is of all the guys to draw to become a monster, that's not the guy. Okay, so there's all of these people on our little board here. Look at this. So much cool stuff is happening here. I do need to get, let's see, 1, 2. No, I need another location. Oh yeah, I drew one right here. The laboratory. Okay, whatever. I need to get a quest done here. So let's go ahead and play. How did I? Oh, all I did was walk so far? All that was just one move into turn four? So a free location play is going to be the laboratory. We'll put that right here. I have to go here. So that's a 3 in what I'm calling the good book now, apparently. The laboratory. The road you're on looks strangely familiar. Ahead, you see a looming cement structure and 2 dilapidated domes rising through the mist. You hear a low, menacing groan. It fades slowly, then you hear the quiet crackling of snapping twigs. Uh-oh. When a player's hero or follower enters this location, read action 28. I have to go there, so I'm going to move. Boom. We got to find 28. I have to just get this quest done, right? So this is the forward momentum of the quest here. 28. Note to the reader, do not read aloud. If the first player-controlled hero who enters this location is Haglore, how funny, we know it's not him. If any player-controlled hero or follower other than Haglore enters, read 34. That's me, baby. 34. You hear the gravel crackle and see it shift near the edge of the road ahead of you. Then you hear brisk footsteps coming towards you. If Haglore's in play, move him here by foot, unnoticed at no cost. Okay. Oh, crud. Remember, he's aggressive. Oh, my God. Oh, my God, this is awful. How did this just happen to me? At no cost. If a player is holding him in hand, place him here and draw him if necessary. Shuffle afterwards, place him here, equip him as necessary. There is a blinding flash of light, and when your eyes refocus, you see a ghostly, semi-transparent figure standing before you. I am Haglore, he says. You've entered a place that is of great importance to me. This guy, like, owns the northwest section of the map here. Like, he is just, this is the space. So, this is interesting. Because now what? I mean, now he's aggressive no matter what. And I feel like this roll won't even matter. A d6 plus luck is going to get me a what? A 5 plus 4 is a 9, right? So if it's 8 or higher, Haglore says, I feel that you're on a noble quest, so I choose to leave you be. I will not haunt you this hour. If Haglore is a player's hero, he may be moved by the controlling player up to 2 locations away. Oh, so I choose to leave you be. I will not haunt you this hour. I feel like... Oh, so wait a second. If Haglore's a... up to two locations away at no cost. If it's interesting. Okay. So he's not a player's hero. He may be moved, so he can't. So he's, the problem is he's going to attack me no matter what, I think, here, right? If Haglor is not a player's hero, he will stay here after this event, and any player who enters this location must roll a d6 plus luck if the... Okay, he will become aggressive to you anyway. Okay, so he's aggressive anyway, so somehow we just got sucked in... This is going to kill us. This guy is a beast. The only good news here is that he did not get to heal that 8 base health, and none of this crap he's going to use. So really, he just has this. So this is kind of a just straight-up Haglor. Let's see here. So can I do something like this? We're going to give him +2 entering combat. Okay, and then he has what? 4 strength. I don't think I need to do all the stats. I just need to do the ones that matter for combat, which are the strength and that. So, okay. Intangibility. Use a battle turn to roll 2d6 plus mind. Oh, so I need his mind score of 3. I don't think the NPCs are like smart, right? He can't attack or take damage. Oh god. If 9 or higher, Haglor becomes intangible. He can't attack or take damage and can instantly flee any battle. No roll. Ends at the beginning of the next game round. So I don't think he would use that, maybe? I don't know. Let's see. We're in trouble now. And there's a lot of glare right there. I apologize. Let's put him up here. Okay, well there's still a lot of glare. All right, so Haglor, buddy, I have these little things I'm using for initiative. So he attacks me. All I've got is my stupid bow, which I would have rather had my daggers for, but I didn't know I was going to get thrown into combat. His roll, 6 plus 3 is... He gets a 9? My roll starts at 4. Oh, God, he beat me. I have an 8. So he gets to go first. So his attack is... Oh my god. Oh, I don't have the king anymore, or the prince anymore. I dumped him off. Okay. He attacks me for 7 plus 4, 4, 5, 6. So 13 points of damage. So 1, 2, 3, 20, down to 22. Oh my god. So I attack. So he goes first. I go second. So now it's my turn. I'm never going to remember to move this thing. I don't know why I bother. Okay, so I get to attack him. So he has what? 0 armor? So I have that going for me. Oh, how many hit points? 34. He did not have a chance to gain hit points, right? Because he just spawned. So I'm going to hit 4. Ooh, that's a good roll. 11, 12. God, I suck, though. I am not a combat person. So what did I say? 11, 12. 12 plus 3 is 15. So we're going to take him down to... 19 hit points. I mean, that was basically maximum I could do. Now he's going to attack me again. This guy's gonna kill me. So 8, 9, 10, plus 4 is 14, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm down to 8 hit points. Okay, but now, no, it won't matter. I don't have my stupid thing equipped. Now I attack him. I take one, I guess, less. I forgot. Wow. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 damage. Wow. Dropping him to 10 hit points, and then he is going to attack me. Yeah, I keep forgetting to use this thing here. He attacks me and just ends my life right there. Boom. Okay, so now I'm dead. I'm unconscious. Now, that's terrible, but I don't really have much of a choice because... Yeah, that stinks. What I can do... So I can use my one thing to stand up and roll the unconscious check, right? So what is the consciousness roll? For 1 AP, which I just spent, on their turn, so it's 3d6 plus mind. If it's 15 or higher, okay, so here we go, 15 or higher. I've got a, wow, I haven't seen 3 sixes in a while. So I made it no matter what, so that pops me back up with 10 hit points. I'm here, and I get to move for free, I believe. However, I also could just, like, sit here, right? Because I don't want this guy to heal. No, here's what we're going to do. We are going to move away because part of that roll, right, is immediately move one location, ignoring any aggressive enemies, and the player continues their turn. Now, I also have the golden bow for 1 action point. You know what? I can switch it out for my longbow. Screw you. Boom, boom. So now I'm going to go... Now I have 4, 5, 6, 5. So I have 1 more speed. I have two less mind, though. That's a bummer. But I'm doing this because once per turn, on your turn, for no AP, you may hit a character in an adjacent location for 1d6 damage. So I'm just going to shoot this guy and try to just take him down a peg. Oh, God. Six. So he's down to 4 hit points now, right? Okay, and I did that because we have to end the round right now, right? Okay, so we just hit that. That was one, that was one, that was one. So that's 3. So we got 2 quest points for that. So we're at 13 now. Okay, right? That was enter 3 different locations that have hex actions. I still don't have a sword and a shield, but I really only need 2 more points. I need to kill a Varping character. He's a ghost. I don't have any healing items. I'm in trouble. Okay, so yeah, see, we're already on round 5. I heal 2. He heals 2, so he's at 6. So there we go. Okay, so now we're on round 5. I somehow need... Now, what is killing him going to get me? Does he have, like, a sword and a shield? I can't even remember. No, he's got some items that I want, though. That's right. I want to kill you and take your stuff. Okay, so start of the round, I get to draw one of these. Maybe I can get a good one here. Oh, that's perfect. Ooh, that's real good. No, it's not. It's not. It's only worth 1 point. Dang. Okay. Dang. I need a sword and a shield. Okay, I've easily gone into 3 player-based things, so I think I only had this one at the time that I pulled that. So, we have to draw some cards. Let's draw this and a character. The glowing... Ooh, Arrow the Horse. I like you. Okay, so now... We got this idiot still. Okay, so here's what we're doing. Oh, man, yeah, we're down to two whole rounds left. I'm actually in a bad spot because I can't place any things for free. So here's what we're going to do. And if I put Arrow there, they're going to fight, and I don't want that to happen. So I could shoot that guy again. This does say defeat an aggressive enemy in combat. That's not in combat. And if I roll a 6, I screw myself out of this. So I don't want to do that. So perhaps I switch up my gear here just a little bit, right? So let's get rid of the bow. So let's just reset all of our stuff. This is one lower because of the body armor, right? And I don't have this +1 anymore. So I'm going to get rid of the bow. Not like discard, just put it in my inventory, right? I'm going to switch up my gear to equip these two things. So the survival knife, and it's funny, I actually have, I'm right here at 12 hit points now. So oddly enough, I get the bonus from it. If it has 12 HP or lower, you gain +1 strength and +1 speed. And then I gain a +1 strength and a +1 speed for that. And then for this, I gain a +1 damage. So I actually have +2 damage now and +1 mind. So my mind is 5-6. So I'm in better shape than I was, I think. Okay, so now I can spend 1 point to go walk in there, right? So we're going to go 1 and walk in here, entering combat, right? So we get to do this again. So I'm going to roll for him first. 5 + 3 = 8. I can beat an 8. I start with a 5. As long as I don't roll just a 3, I'm good. Ooh, that was close. So I got 5 + 5 is going to give me 10. So I get to go first, and I am going to roll poorly. So that's 5 plus 5 is 10. 11, 12 damage, right? 12 damage. That's enough to kill, though, right? Yeah, so that's fine. I can even do extra poison damage. That doesn't matter. All I wanted to do was kill this idiot. Okay, so this guy's dead. I just killed Ghost Man here, right? So he's dead. I'm going to discard him. That's fine. And there's these 3 items sitting there. Now, he has a ghost sword. Is there a shield in this zone? Oh, there is. Not zone. I mean, this thing. Oh, come on. Yeah. There's a shield in the discard. So I'm going to pick up... Do I have a sword here? No, I don't. Okay, I have to play this very carefully. I'm going to pick up the sword. I cannot pick up all of it in one round. It's just a rule of the game. You can't sit here and just like loot bodies for all their stuff, but you can once per round. So next turn, if I can be here, I can pick up a... Let's see here. One of these 2 things is going to get me a shield, I feel like, right? Meditate on 1 lost item or person. Press the button, and this arcane device will send a spear of light into the sky from their location. Okay, for 1 AP, draw any 1 item or character that is related to an active heroic quest. Shuffle after. So, it sounds like that might be a specific thing. Right? The rift crystal, though. So I can try to press my luck. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, you know what? In fact, we're gonna leave the sword and we're gonna take the rift crystal first. That's what we're doing. So this stuff is just sitting in this location because I can farm this out and win this game if I can do this right. So I'm gonna take the rift crystal. The reason I'm taking the rift crystal is because I can heal myself with it as well. And it doesn't cost an action, right? So we kind of have to like play the. Oh, I forgot that I got bonus damage too. On a roll of 4, add +2 damage for each. Just out of curiosity, I forget when I'm using a bow, right? When using a bow. If I roll a 4, okay, so it wouldn't have mattered in my little combat. Okay. So I'm gonna crush the rift crystal that I picked up off his dead body. Heals me for 5, right? So that means I lose a speed and lose a strength. I go from 12 to 17 hit points. And then that says take 3 cards, right? And I'm doing this on purpose because there's a rift crystal in here. So if I'm lucky, I can kind of like cheat until I get myself a shield. Okay. Right? Item discard pile, draw 3 cards from it, place one into the inventory of my hero, then discard the other two. So I have one of those, and these are all in the discard. Both of what I want are in here. That kind of sucks a little bit, though, right? Because I want the shield, right? I don't want to have to fight the princess. I want the shield because I want the sword that I can pick up from this spot. Now that gets discarded. Okay. So unfortunately, I mean, really at this point in this game, all I have to do is end this round, start the new round, pick up the sword, and then walk one space over, drop the stuff, and gain 4 quest points. That is literally all I have to do, right? I could also like, you know, throw a horse down here and take a follower, but none of that is worth it to me when I could. Well, let's just for fun. How interesting. That's kind of weird. Okay, I mean, just for fun, let's throw one and draw a card. Egg armor. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, we'll do it again and draw a card. I just kind of want to see 7. Oh, enchanted. I was hoping to draw a sword, right? Just to be done with it. Oh, wait. Oh, and we killed an aggressive enemy in combat, so that's one more point, right? We just did that. I'm never going to have 3 healing items. I just tried to get some, and I've got 0. Right, so if that's the end of the round, we do that. We heal for 2. 1, 2. It's the new round. I get 2 cards, but I've got to drop some stuff, so we may as well drop. It kind of doesn't matter what I drop. Let's drop egg armor and actually let's discard egg armor. I don't even know what it does. Let's draw 2 new cards. No sword. Ooh, Dread Mortis. This guy looks like a scary individual. Moonseed Elixir. I can't believe I can't draw a stupid sword anywhere, right? So then we pick up the sword from this spot, the ghost sword. Right? When equipped, ghost faction. I'm not a ghost guy, but I can still carry it, right? I can pick this up. I can equip it. I have 8 items. That's good enough. I can spend 1 to move. Ta-da! Have your hero enter. Right? So there it is. Okay. Enter to. Let's see. I've gone to 3 player locations, equipped them with a new sword and a new shield. Okay, right. So. Requires 4 luck to equip. Ooh, wait a second. Oh! Oh my god! Oh my god! I can only do that because I have the body armor. Because I only have 3 luck. 4 luck requires 4 luck to equip. The body armor is +1 luck. That's a one-handed sword. I lucked out. I didn't literally. I didn't realize I had to have 4 luck to equip that thing. And it has to be equipped. Have your hero, yeah. Equip them with a new sword and a new shield, and then return them with these items equipped to the crossroads, boom, to gain 4 quest points. So there is that was the round. 1, 2, 3, 4. Right now, just for fun, what if I burn a thing? Oh, what if I searched here? Yeah, before we walk over there, what if we search? Right? If I have all my previous gear, it's 6 plus the roll, which is 8, so I can draw 3 and keep 1. See, I could have even had this. I found this sword laying here in the ground. I could walk over there and take that. Wow. Wow. Okay. But then we do that anyway. What if we dropped all this garbage? And we had just that. We dropped all this stuff right there. And then we equipped a Moonseed Elixir. Oh, see, I don't have one more healing thing, right? Don't I have a three healing thing? I do. So I could use my last thing. If this is a healing thing, Warlock Talisman. Oh, didn't I have a thing here somewhere for that? No. Okay, that's a bummer. That would have been funny to be able to do a three healing thing, but that's it. If that's the end of the game, and then I somehow barely made it with 18 points, this game is incredible, and you can keep going, right? So the way that this is supposed to work, if you're going to do a long game, is right here at the Meridian, you draw another heroic quest, right? And boom, there we are. Heroic quest, you're cursed. Oh no. What does it say? You're cursed. You trip over the arm of a half-buried man. You know him. He is Rake the Void, an evil warlock. He scowls at you. What? You trip over the arm of a half... Oh, he's half-buried. He scowls at you, and with his last breath, he quietly whispers an evil incantation and slumps over dead. You are encircled by a dark mist. Lose 2 health now. 17. And at the beginning of each new round, instead of gaining 2 health, your hero in there... Actually, oh, that's funny. Because, see, I wouldn't have needed to get the ghost sword had I the other thing. The sword I drew, whatever I did with it. Did I throw it away? Yeah, this sword. Requires 4 strength or it's two-handed. It gives no strength. So I wouldn't have been able to equip that, actually. Oh, wow. You are encircled by a dark mist. Lose 2 health now, and at the beginning of each round, lose 2 more health. Right? So you're cursed. Your hero... That's not cursed. Poisoned is... We'll say maybe it's blue. Maybe that's it. Your hero or their follower must drop 6 items onto the ground, never to be picked up again by your... Oh, wow, I just dropped a ton of stuff, right? Gain 1 quest point for each of the 6 items that are dropped, and then discard this card to end the curse, right? So what you could do is go ahead and say, I jump all of these things, right? Or I only need to drop 6 things, because, oh, no, we already, you know, went through here. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 items. I only need 1, right? Do we just keep a sword? I can't equip this when I'm not strong enough. But anyway... That's 6 more points. I could easily get 6 points, which would put me at, what, 24? That's pretty easy to get this, which is why I think that it's fun to do this solo ranked game thing over here. Once you kind of realize you're focused on just doing quests to get those points instead of just explore an adventure. But anyway, I absolutely love this game. I cannot stop thinking about it. Every single time I have played, it has been its own new story. This is the kind of game that literally writes short stories as you play. It's just phenomenal. It is just an amazing game. And, you know, these books here, all you need to do is release a book, you know, C, a book series of C or whatever. I don't know what the expansions have, but like, you know, he could just put out, you know, Rob Lemon, the artist, the designer here, creator, complete everything by himself, could just release 2 new books. This is a new expansion, you know, whatever. Put it out for inexpensive, boom, here you go. New expansion, maybe 2 or 3 cards with it, you know, or whatever. Have a nice day. Here's a whole new journey. Changes everything you already have here because we already have all the locations we could ever need. But what they do could be different in the books. This game is phenomenal. Absolutely worth $44 for the base game. I don't know about the expansions yet, but I can only imagine adding more to this system could only be better. This game is phenomenal. This is Dark Venture by Rob Lemon, and his company is Gilded Skull Games, and it's been my pleasure to play this game again. It is so fun. It's all I've been thinking about for 2.5 weeks, I think, now, really. I really do. Ever since I read the rule book, so it was shortly after I finally got it in my grubby little hand. So until then, remember, games are made for everyone's recreation. We'll see you next time.